Welcome to this video in which we will discuss different structures of recursive filters, that is, filters with at least one feedback loop, and non-recursive filters, that is, filters without a feedback loop. The most common form of a non-recursive filter is a so-called transversal filter, or tap delay line, as depicted in the figure. Because of the finite length of the filter, and since there are no feedback loops, the coefficients of the impulse response Hn are the same as the coefficients of the filter. So we denote the impulse response coefficients as H0 until Hm-1, as depicted in the figure. In previous videos, we've seen that the shown system is a causal FAR filter, since its impulse response has finite length and the output signal Y depends only on current and previous values of the input signal X. The difference equation and system function are given by the equations. The system function contains, except poles in Z as 0, only zeros. For each new index, n, evaluating the resulting sum requires m multiplications and m-1 additions. Finally, the structure is always stable. The system function H of the non-recursive structure may be factored into a product of first-order factors, as shown in the equation, where alpha k, for k is 1 until m-1, are the zeros of the system function H. If the complex roots of the system function H occur in complex conjugate pairs, these conjugate pairs may be combined to form second-order factors with real coefficients. When writing H in this form, the filter can be implemented as a cascade of second-order non-recursive structures, as illustrated in the figure, and the impulse response of such a system has real coefficients. The equation describes the difference equation of a recursive system. Its rational system function H contains a numerator polynomial B and a denominator polynomial A. From this mathematical description, we will show in the following slides that we can derive the following recursive structures. Multiply B with 1 divided by A results in the direct form 1. And, the other way around, multiply 1 divided by A with B results in the direct form 2 structure. The cascade structure, which can be derived by factoring both B and A, and finally the parallel structure, which results by using the partial fraction expansion. The direct form 1 structure is an implementation which follows from the description of the system function H as the product of the non-recursive part B with the recursive part 1 divided by A, as shown in the figure. The direct form 2 structure, which follows from the description of the system function H as a product, but now the other way around. There's first the recursive part, 1 divided by A, and then the non-recursive part B. From this direct form 2 structure, it's obvious that we can combine delays, which results in a direct form 2 structure, which is canonic, since it uses the minimum number of delays for the given system function H. The cascade structure is derived by factoring the numerator and denominator polynomials and using these factors to write the system function H as a product. The factorization corresponds to a cascade of first-order filters, each having one pole and one zero. In general, the coefficients alpha k and beta k will be complex. As mentioned before, when the impulse response H is real, the roots of the system function H will occur in complex conjugate pairs, and these complex conjugate factors may be combined to form second-order factors with real coefficients. As an example, we can factor the system function H of the given third-order recursive filter as a product of a first-order recursive structure H1z in red and a second-order recursive structure H2z in blue. Both filters have real coefficients. This system can be realized as a cascade of the direct form 2 structures of H1 and H2 respectively. The pole 0 plot shows the real pole and zero of the first order system in red and the complex conjugated pairs of poles and zeros of the second order system in blue. The magnitude and phase plot of the frequency response is represented in the plot at the right-hand side. An alternative way to factoring the system function H is to expand the system function using a partial fraction expansion. This corresponds to a sum of subsystems which can be realized by connecting these subsystems in parallel. Each of these subsystems may be first-order filters with complex impulse response coefficients. If the impulse response H has real coefficients, the poles of the system function H will occur in complex conjugate pairs, which can be combined to form second-order systems with real coefficients. As an example, we can split the second-order recursive system function H by using partial fraction expansion into a sum of 3 subsystems, which can be realized by connecting these subsystems in parallel as shown in the figure. Finally, in practice it's important to have as many alternative structures available as possible to realize a filter. A general method of deriving from any given structure another structure from which the input-output properties remain unchanged is based on the so-called transposition theorem. The different steps to obtain a transposed structure are explained based on the direct form 1 realization of the third order transversal filter as depicted in the figure. The first step is to reverse the direction of all branches, and the second step is to interchange branch points, as denoted in blue bullets in the figure, into summation nodes, denoted in red in the figure, and the other way around, which results into a new structure as depicted in the second figure. The third step is to interchange the input X and the output Y, which results in this example into the direct form 2 realization of the third order transversal filter. This ends this video in which we discussed different recursive and non-recursive filter structures. Thank you for your attention.